Hello everyone, welcome for this PowerPoint about Plane Collect 2.0. We will see about some teardown strategy, which weeks and gear you have to choose, what is your budget estimation depending on which tier you want to run, the possible return on investment, and also my personal strategy. So in the new Plane Collect, you have four possible tiers of runnings, which are accessible based on your gear score. So if you are between 0 and 130, you can run the tier 1, 130 to 220 tier 2, etc. And it costs a bit more credits or some even runs depending on which tier you run. And you also require some levels to be winning some events. And so the aim will be to reach the max gear score in each tier for the one you want to run to be able to win 80% of the encounters, which is the maximum possible. So for tier 3, you will need 580. And you would also try to have the maximum level to be able to win the events that also happen during the runs. And as you can see, the loot distribution is mainly events for loot capsules and mystery boxes for encounters. So they are both really important to have the good gear score and the VX level. Here is a table of all the gear sets and their value. So the leg, chest, arm, shield, and weapon, which give a total. And if there is the set bonus, which is based on the chest value, so here 22, you get a bit more. Then I also check which Genesis weapon and shield has the most gear score value within the same rarity. So here it's 52. And when you use a Genesis weapons or shield, it can replace a weapon or shield from the set and still give the set bonus that we got there. And since it gives 52 instead of 24, we get a bit more at the end, so we go from 132 to 188. And then based on the gear score of your VX, you get a bit more gear score in total, so 208 if you have 20, 223 if you have 35, 148 if you have 60. Generally, the gear score of the VX is between 0 and 60. There are a few ones that are above 60, and the maximum is 120. And so, if you want to buy a specific set and reach a specific gear score, here you have everything. And now, I will explain what is the budget for each wanted tier that you want to run. So from this table, if you aim for the tier 1, you only need the gear score of 130. So the cheapest set is like $52, or whatever one you want, because it's always above 130. And if you get a VX with gear score 0 and level 1 or 6, it's around $800 or almost $1,000. Then if you aim for tier 2, which is maximum 320 gear score, the cheapest set is at 354, so 7 times more expensive than for tier 1. And if you want a level 8 VX, it would be at 238 RON, so $1,000. And normally it's level 9 for winning all the events, but level 8 is quite close, so that's why I choose level 8. And then the most important thing we can see from this table is for tier 3, that you have two ways of reaching the maximum winning rate on tier 3. You can either go the rare gear way, which is cheaper, or the epic gear way. If you go the rare gear way, you will need at least a VX with a gear score of 35 and maybe some levels. So, for example, there was one at 475 RON for $2,000. That's the one I bought, so just for reference. And to reach 583, you need the Night Force gear, which is a new set that is coming from the new PNK. So it gives 78, 83, 78 gear score. And you would also need the two Genesis weapons and shield, which are the best one in the rare category, which are the Kong Bone for the weapon and the Spiked Steel Guard for the shield. And overall, this whole set cost me $450. $450 or $2,000. So in total, you would spend almost $4,000 for the VX plus the gear. But you can maybe buy a lower level VX and level it step by step instead of paying a lot more all at once. The other way is the epic gear way. So here you don't care about the gear score of the VX. You only need whatever epic set you want, since it gives at least 600 gear score, and you only need 583. So here an epic set is at least almost $5,000 plus a VX of level 13, 1,260. And so you would need $6,200 compared to the $4,000 for doing the same thing on tier 3. And also, I don't really recommend using the epic gear on tier 4 because the gear score is still quite low compared to the maximum possible, which is 1,640. And so then, if you aim for the legendary gear for the tier 4, it's probably too expensive. So first, if you want a level 20 VX, you need 538 Ronin, which is $2,200. And there are no set for sale yet. So it would be really expensive to get that. And even with that, you don't reach 1,640 with a VX of gear score 60. Then, for the possible prizes that you could get, there are the Mystery Box rewards from Common to Legendary. In a Common, you will often have the really lowest rewards possible, but for example, in the Legendary one, there is no more Common rewards, but there is a higher chance of getting Legendary rewards, so like 100 Ronin, 50 Axes, 100 Banana, or a Legendary Loot Capsule. At the time of this video, there was no Legendary Loot Capsule which was dropped yet, so they are quite wanted. And for example, these are the current prices of the new capsule that you get from PNK. So if you get an epic one, it's already $1,000. If somehow you manage to get four of them, you would compensate the tier 3 rare set that I explained before. And since everything is based on luck, you could maybe get nothing, maybe get a lot. So this is not financial advice, you have to do your own research. And if you really run the highest possible gear score in a tier, you will get more rewards, more congium that you can also commit to get banana at the end of the season. Or if you do 30k credits of run, you are also participating in the jackpot pool. And so what is my own strategy? So mine is to get the 583 gear score. So this is a VX with gear score 35, at least level 14 for the winning all the events of tier 3. And having the Night Force legs, chest and arm, and the Kongbone and Spike Steel Guard Genesis weapons and shield. This will allow a successful tier 3 run. And the tier 3 runs as epic capsules and also the legendary mystery boxes that you win when you encounter these Cyber Kongs here, this opponent. And they could contain legendary capsule and other things. And now let's see if this strategy works in real time on this VX that is level 15 with a gear score of 583, so above the tier 3 limit, and with the Night Force equipment for the chest, arms and legs, and the Kongbone and Spiked Steel Guard for the Genesis weapon and shield. Let's open what we got, which is only one epic mystery box. Almost at 5 rounds, so 25 rounds. But I spent 30 bananas, which is $120, more or less. And I only got $20 back. So, not worth it. So, in the end, it's 50 rounds were not really worth it, since it is really based on luck. So, up to you to do what you want with the VX, the gear, and also good luck to everyone for the new PNK.